Another big news after Dr. Parag Agrawal becoming the CEO of Twitter. Dr. Geeta Gopinath is now going to hold the second most powerful position at the International Monetary Fund IMF. Since 2019, Dr. Gopinath was serving as the chief economist at the IMF. Why is this such an important news? What does the profile of Dr. Geeta Gopinath look like? What kind of research does she do? Let us find out. Dr. Gopinath attended the University of Delhi, where she went to Lady Shri Ram College, and she got her graduation degree, a bachelor's degree in 1992 in economics. Then she pursued her master's at Delhi University, where she got her master's degree in 1994. And then immediately after, she went to the US and she attended the University of Washington for her second master's, again in economics. After finishing her master's degree from University of Washington, she went to Princeton University, where she pursued her doctoral degree in economics and graduated with a PhD in economics in 2001. In her PhD, she specialized in international macroeconomics and trade. Dr. Gopinath is also a Desi American professor, by the way. She is a professor of economics at Harvard University. After her PhD from Princeton, she went to University of Chicago at their Booth School of Business, and she worked as an assistant professor. In 2005, she left University of Chicago and moved to Harvard University again as an assistant professor. In 2009, she was tenured and was promoted to an associate professor at Harvard University. And the very next year, she was promoted again, and then she became a full professor of economics at Harvard University. In 2019, Dr. Gopinath took a sabbatical from Harvard University for public service, where she went to IMF to become the chief economist. That said, it is nothing uncommon. Dr. Gopinath is not the first person to take a sabbatical from her job as a professor to serve in public institutions. Dr. Raghuram Rajan is a good example, who is a professor at University of Chicago right now, but he took a sabbatical and went to India to serve as the governor of RBI. Dr. Raghuram Rajan was from IIT Delhi, and then he got his MBA from IIM Ahmedabad, and then he got his PhD from MIT. Similarly, Dr. Arjit Patel, who has a PhD from Yale University in economics, served as the governor. In fact, he replaced Dr. Raghuram Rajan as the governor of RBI. And Dr. Urjit Patel had also worked for the IMF. Now the question is, what is IMF and why is this position so important? The IMF comprises of 190 countries with the goal to reduce poverty and give financial assistance for countries to develop and grow. These days, however, IMF has been in news in South Asian media because of Pakistan in particular. At the moment, Pakistan is at the brink of becoming a bankrupt country. In a true sense, it is already bankrupt. IMF loans and recently Saudi aid has kept Pakistan afloat. Or else it is only a matter of time when Pakistan economy has a total collapse. The situation has been so bad that recently Pakistan's embassy in Serbia tweeted that they have not received their paychecks. They have not even paid for the last 3 months. Immediately after, that statement on Twitter was retracted by the government of Pakistan, claiming that the account was hacked in an attempt for cover-up and face saving. India was also in a similar situation in the 1990s, where India had to seek financial aid from the IMF. But then the Indian economy went through liberalization, and India learned its lessons. Unlike Pakistan, India started relying on its own income and not depend on foreign assistance and borrowed money for its growth. In summary, IMF is a very critical and a very powerful global organization. Many countries, in fact, depend on the IMF for their survival even. And therefore, holding a powerful position at a powerful organization is a very big deal. And that is why it is important to understand what is Dr. Gopinath's profile like that got her that position. There has to be reasons why she got such fantastic opportunities, right? So let us examine her profile. First thing first, in her doctoral dissertation, Dr. Gopinath examined international capital flows. Specifically, her dissertation research was on decisions to invest in foreign countries, impact of the investment on the industry productivity in the country where investments are made, and how the behavior of the investors create congestions by reducing the likelihood of finding high return projects in the economy. After finishing her dissertation, Dr. Gopinath published many influential and high profile scientific papers in prestigious journals in economics and also served in high editorial roles. In her research, Dr. Gopinath has examined a variety of topics that include emerging market business cycles, defaultable debts, interest rates, policy frameworks, international price system, and even India's demonetization. In her research on demonetization, she showed that when 86% of India's currency was demonetized, districts that experienced more severe impact of demonetization had a reduction in economic activities, where people were not able to buy and sell goods. But then these areas also saw faster adoption rates of electronic currency exchange technologies. In addition to this, Dr. Gopinath's research has also examined other interesting topics such as US-China trade tensions and the economic impacts of COVID lockdowns. Dr. Gopinath is a perfect example of somebody who has pursued a single line of study. All her life, she has been studying economics to become an economist. But it is interesting to note that she did not start her public service by working at the IMF. She was in the advisory group on the G20 matters at the Ministry of Finance at the Government of India. Then she worked as an economic advisor for the Government of Kerala. She then kept building up her profile as she became the member of Economic Advisory Panel at the Federal Reserve Bank of New York. Then eventually in 2019, she became the chief economist at the IMF. And the chief economist position itself is a very powerful position, but she was about to end that tenure and return to Harvard to be a full-time professor again. But in a surprise move, she is now promoted to be the second most powerful person at the IMF. So this was a brief summary of Dr. Geeta Gopinath's career. I hope you found this video to be informative. Thank you for watching. Jai Hind and God bless America.